ready. It's 2022's biggest disappointment of the year for us here at the channel. And I have to say, from our biggest disappointment came our, I would say, one of our most revealing and insightful moments for the channel. Now let's back up. For almost 2 years, I've been chronicling the making and with excitement and energy on Namor, the Submariner, who is going to make his debut in the movie Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. I seemingly did videos on any and every rumor, Spanish interview, announcement, post that the actor Tenoch Huerta made. Every move he made, we did a video on. With excitement and with also, too, gaining knowledge from our comic book friends on Namor the Submariner. Now, when we also heard that this character would be kind of reimagined as a Mesoamerican, I still had my excitement, but that's when I started having some caution. Some caution in the care for the history, for the complicated history of not only Maya and Mexica, but just on the whole outlook on colonialism and kingdom versus kingdom well before Cortez even showed up. So I know it was a lot. So that's a lot of heavy lifting that I was like, wow, Coogler has a lot on his hands. Now, that being said, I still went and saw this movie with optimism because that's really how I'm wired. And of course, as you know, I was not happy with the movie. So when we did this review, a live review, when I got out of the theater, little did I know that Mexican Iron Man's rant that was on my channel first, and then subsequently you saw it on Midnight's Edge, which was fantastic. It was such a touchstone moment of an honest moviegoer who's not, you know, part of the entertainment machine. He's not in the entertainment business. He is your typical avid moviegoer and, you know, a bit of a nerd as well. But this Mexican-American wanted to love this as well. And that's what he had went there going for. So I will send you the link. I will put the link in this video so you can see the whole rant. But right now, let's go to a clip of his rant.
Crap. What I just saw right now is a disservice to men, a disservice to comic book fans, a disservice to fans of cinema, a disservice to Mexicans, and a disservice to Mexican minority relations. And let me tell you this much. I saw this movie for all of you. Anybody listening to my review, if you pay to go and see this movie, then let's go through what you're going to get. All right? I don't even need to spoil it just to tell you what you're going to get. It's not made for Mexicans, at least not if you want to have any pride. It sure as hell not meant for fathers, because there's absolutely no redeeming qualities here from a father's perspective. It sure as hell better not be made for little boys, because if you hope your boy to become a man, this is not the hero movie for you. It sure is not about families, because the basic undercurrent theme of this thing is vengeance. This is not a movie about love. This is not a movie about heroism. This is a poorly written sack of shit movie that went for the 2 hours and 45 minutes I sat in there. This story could have been told in an hour and 4 minutes flat. And even then probably would have been too long. I'm insulted as a Mexican. And by the way, Pauly, we weren't even Mexican in this thing. We were blue. You can see this one and see all the fucking blue people you want. There are so many pieces of crap in this. How do they talk underwater? Don't know.
So obviously we were disappointed, to say the least, as you can see from that clip alone. And just when I say biggest disappointment, I mean in portrayal, in storytelling, in execution of not only Namor, which was an incredible character, but a Mesoamerican, reimagined one. And that was my biggest disappointment, was that portrayal in that film, for many reasons, but that's the one here as far as the Latino slant. Now, what had happened is an avalanche of support of Mexican Ironman's rant and of the channel New Eyeballs and their own feelings as well of just pure, I don't even know what the words are, to be honest. It ranged from anger to disappointment to offensive. I mean, you guys had it all. You guys had it all. And when I say you guys, I meant people of every background as well. Submariner fans, Latinos, Mexican-Americans, Chicanos, Black people, people from all different walks on your big disappointment in this iteration of Namor. So from that, though, that touchstone moment and that avalanche, it said to me that entertainment is for the audience. That's who you should be entertaining. And because of that, that is unfortunately our Latino Slant's biggest disappointment here. Don't live my life.